Physicist Brian Schwartz has investigated the fall in detail and believes the platform itself may have contributed to Alcides' survival in another way.
It's a very improbable event. If it were to happen again, the likelihood of survival is very, very small. The platform had a total area of 55 square feet, so that presented a fairly wide area, and as a result, the drag force was quite large. That cuts the velocity by about 50 miles an hour.
When objects fall, air resistance pushes up to oppose the force of gravity pulling down. This is called drag. If they hadn't been on the platform, they would have hit the ground at around 110 miles or 177 kilometers an hour. But the force of drag was pushing up against the bottom of the platform and slowed it to around 60 miles or 96 kilometers an hour.
It's better than 110, but 60 miles an hour is still fast enough to really result in usually death.
So drag alone could not account for Alcides' miraculous survival. Investigators continued searching for another piece of the puzzle. Searching for an explanation, investigators discovered evidence that Alcides Moreno may have been saved during the final second of the accident, when the platform's fall was broken just before it hit the ground.
What we can see here is we can see scrape marks and some damage to a parapet on one of the windows, and then a scrape going down the face of the building. And this is where we believe that the side of the scaffold platform impacted the short building next to it.
It may have been just at this moment of impact that Edgar Moreno was thrown from the platform and killed. We do know that Alcides remained on the platform, and his descent velocity slowed as he approached the pavement.
The fall occurred in a certain way in which the sides of the scaffolding hit the buildings there in the alleyway, and as a result, the landing was a lot longer and a lot softer than it would have been had he just hit the ground flat.
Investigators believed a crucial piece of the puzzle involved the moment of impact. At the very last second, the platform struck a low wall and was bent in half as it became wedged in the alleyway below.
When the platform impacted the adjacent building in that short wall, it collapsed into a V.
Alcides' fall was broken as the platform folded. This lessened the force of impact. But the platform also protected him in another remarkable way.
Being a big fan of NASCAR and growing up with the family, we've always watched these horrific crashes where the car rolls and burns, and all of a sudden you see a hand go in and releases a seatbelt. And a guy walks away from a crash, and you scratch your head and you say, well, how did he survive that, you know? And this, in my opinion, is exactly how he survived. I believe that the platform created a roll cage and protected his body.
This was confirmed by Gary Smiley when he first discovered Alcides.
The scaffold hit the retaining wall, went into a V, and then he was kind of folded into that and almost created like a pocket where it absorbed some of the energy.
The platform acted like a spring in some sense, that it broke his fall.
Because the platform bent around Alcides like a roll cage, his head and limbs were protected at the moment of impact.